What is up, you guys? It is your girl Megan, and I'm back with another video here to tell you everything that you can do in Colorado. River canyons and snow-covered Rocky Mountains, which mainly cover Rocky Mountain National Park. Rocky Mountain National Park is known for the highest national parks in the nation, with elevations of mountain ranges reaching 7,800 feet to 14,000 feet. It has 60 mountain peaks that cover 12,000 foot high mountain ranges that give you a life-changing scenery experience. It has multiple things to offer, like tours, hiking ranges, hiking trails, and you can even go down to some of the canyons and view some of the amazing experiences that it has to offer. Massive Verde National Park, which was founded by Theodore Roosevelt, opened the park to preserve the works of man's hands to give others an idea of what life was like for people who lived during the times of 550 AD to 1200 AD. This national park features cliff dwellings, which also offer 4,700 archaeological sites, including 600 cliff dwellings that you can see, and most of them you actually have to see with a tour, but I'm going to tell you all about them. There is about 600 different cliff dwellings that you can see. Some are open during the winter and some are open from the summer to the winter. For example, the Longhouse, which is open from May 29 to October 22nd. Step House can be visited during this time as well, and October 23rd to the 31st, you can go visit Cliff Palace. Cliff Palace, which is actually the main one, has about 150 different rooms, or you can look at it from the 6 mile drive that overlooks the cliff dwellings and is actually really good for photography. Balcony House, which is 10 minutes away from the Cliff Palace, does have a ladder that you would have to climb up to actually see the inside of it, but you do need a tour to go see that. Balcony House has about 40 different rooms that you can go see, but that one you do need a tour. And of course, Denver, Colorado is a sight to see in itself. Denver, Colorado has so many different things to see, like breweries. It has history, like Denver Art Museum. So, like I said, Denver Art Museum has so many different cultures in the art in itself, like the Asian culture, the arts of Oceania, which features art from different islands such as Samoa, Tonga, and Hawaii. So it really helps you understand the different art cultures and how they progress over the hundreds of thousands of years that they've been in the museum. So I'm going to go through the list of some of the different arts that they have so you can really understand the different cultural aspects that they have in the museum. You have modern and contemporary art, which was the art officially was founded in 1978 and touched upon 7,000 different artworks made between 1900 and now. You have artwork from Robert Motherwell to Herbert Byer to woman arts of abstract expressionism. So you have different artworks from different people that really help you understand modern and contemporary art that transgressed over the hundreds of years that it has been inside the museum. Photography art, which is my personal favorite, touches on the American West history from 1865 to present. This section helps us really understand how photography has shifted over the last centuries. You have film, which is my favorite. I have so many film cameras and I love how different they are to today. You have self-portraits, you have nature photography, you have light fixture photography, which really helps us understand the changes to photography that have been made over the hundreds of years. Latin American art, featuring over 3,000 works of art from Mexico, Central America, South America, the Caribbean, and the Southwestern United States, helps us focus on the art that emerged after the independence from European rule in the 1820s. This is when the love of art bursted forth in that region because people were searching for national identity through their art, and as they found it, it just grew over the thousands of years. Circling back to Samoan culture, there is a giant sculptural piece called Lei Bombing. It uses hundreds of leis to make an installation. If you are into drinking in breweries, Denver is also known for their breweries, and one of the top rated is Blue Moon Brewing Company, and it is also seating, free parking, and apparently a good grilled pork sandwich. So definitely check it out if you are in Denver and enjoy brewing companies. Another thing to do in Denver, Colorado, if you've ever watched the Titanic and heard of the Unsinkable Molly Brown, her house is in the very heart of Denver, Colorado. So if you're interested in a tour of her house, this is definitely something to go see. And I'm about to tell you all the history on her, why she ended up on the Titanic, and who she was as a person before the Titanic. Full name, Margaret Tobin. She was the Unsinkable Molly Brown, who was the very woman on the Titanic who actually survived. And funny thing is, after the Titanic sunk, she wasn't even able to give a testimony on the Titanic and everything that happened because she was a woman. She married and met her husband in July 18th, 1854, and he was not rich at all like her husband expected. But she said, "It is better to date a poor man who I love than a wealthy man who attracts me for his money." They actually had two children, Larry and Catherine Ellen Brown, and they started to become a success when her husband's mining company started to take off, while Margaret helped in the soup kitchen to assist miners. In 1894, they bought a beautiful $30,000 Victorian house, which is now known as the Molly Brown House, that you can go see to this very day. Molly spent most of her time in Paris visiting her daughter when she found out from a word in Denver that her son was seriously ill. So what did she do? She booked the very first cruise so she could head to New York on the PMS Titanic, but that didn't go very well because it sank in 1912. She tried to help others aboard like the kind-hearted woman she was, but finally she was persuaded to abandon the sinking ship and take on safety in lifeboat number 6, where she did survive on. So a little bit of her life after she survived the Titanic. In 1914, 6 years before the 19th Amendment came out, giving the woman the right to vote, she ran for Colorado's U.S. Senate and ended her campaign to serve as the American Committee for Devastated France during World War I. Fast forward to her long-lived life, after doing many things as a career, she died peacefully in her bed in October 26, 1932, at age 65, and had a funeral on the 31st. And that is the life of Molly Brown, who went on the Titanic, and you can find all that out personally on the tour in her house. You can go see her bed, you can go see her house, and you can go see where she allowed her kids to grow up. Or if you're a big hiker, Black Canyon at the Gunnison National Park, which has mountain ranges elevations from 400 feet to 8,400 feet, and the best place to see is Warner National Park, which is about a mile and a half of a walk. Personally, to me, the best part of this place is you can go to the bottom of the canyon to go see the bottom of the river, which is about a mile and a half to 2 miles down and takes about 4 to 6 hours round trip to complete it there and back. Black Canyon Trail in itself is 17 miles round trip. Another top rated thing that you can go see is Red Rock Canyon, which consists of great sandstone cliffs that are about 180 to 190 million years old and was discovered during the Jurassic time. You can hike the actual canyon in itself for about 1.4 miles and takes about 1.5 hours to complete. If you are a tour junkie like me, you can go and take a train that takes you around the Royal George Bridge. And that personally is a 360 window view tram car that takes you through the mountains and allows you to see beautiful mountain ranges and beautiful scenery. That is highly recommended. If you are an outdoors man, Hanging Lake with 7 miles of springs and a swimming hole that allows you to walk up the 1.5 mile trail to see the top of the waterfall is something that is also top rated. And I highly recommend that you take an opportunity to go look at that, especially if you have kids and you're going for the summertime. Last but not least, for an in-detail description, Maroon Bells with a 14,000 foot mountain peak with a lake that you cannot swim in, but is definitely beautiful to see, allowing you to hike. But the best way to see it is to take a public transportation with possible chance to have the place all to yourselves. So if you want to go all the way up to the mountain peak and see a beautiful range of the mountain, definitely take the public transportation and do not miss it, because you might have the mountain all to yourself. So finally, in conclusion, there are endless things to do in Colorado, most of which I mentioned are outside, because Colorado is mainly known for their mountain ranges, beautiful hiking trails, waterfalls, and scenery that you just don't want to miss. But there are things to do inside, like the Denver Downtown Aquarium, Denver Museum of Nature and Science, Denver Union Station, International Church of Cannabis, if you are into that, and the Museum of Mountain West, and so much more, which takes you through what life was like back in the Wild Wild West. Thank you so much much for watching this, and I hope you book a trip to Colorado, because it is definitely a place to go if you are going on vacation.